Hey there, guys. A new lesson for you today, and a very important one. It's how to learn your freaking guitar fretboard and see anything you want to see without getting confused. If you are one of those people who search a secret, a shortcut, or just want to entertain their girlfriends in the campfire playing cowboy chords, then this video isn't for you. This is for people who want to start taking command of the fretboard, but don't know where to start. So, what this video will do is number the steps needed in order to achieve this. I'll make more videos in the future to explain every step in detail, but right now you have to be able to see the big picture. If after viewing the video you will say, okay, or I'm really bored to do this stuff, then let's face it, you didn't want to learn the fretboard that much in the first place. So, with that being said, let's start. Number one, learn at least all the natural notes on the fretboard. I have already made a video with suggestions on how you do that, but the bottom line is that if I ask you what note is in the 10th fret of the high string, for example, and you don't know that the answer is D immediately without thinking or counting, then you don't know that note. You simply don't know it. It's not something, of course, you will learn by today or by the next few weeks, but make sure each day you get a little better at recognizing the natural notes. 5 minutes a day, it's all it takes. Take one note and recognize it at some of the frets. Of course, I've made a video, as I've said before, with the details on how you learn the entire fretboard, but the natural notes are more than enough to get you where you want to get. You already know some of them from all that power chord banging anyway, so it's time to learn the rest. Number two, learn all the intervals visually on the fretboard. Again, I have already made a video about it, so go check it out and start familiarizing yourself with the fretboard distances, even if it's just on the visual level at first. You don't have to devote so much time, and you don't have to be able to know them by the end of the day, next week. Okay, like I said before, a few minutes a day, it's more than enough. Okay, doesn't have to be really complicated. You have one note, any note here, figure out what the distance is between this and that. Okay, you have to know that, but just by looking at it, that this is a major third, like this, or this is a perfect fifth, oh, sorry, like this, or like this, and so on. Okay, it may sound to you trivial at first to know these things, but seriously, make some effort. You will soon find out that this is the missing link that connects everything, and you don't have to strain yourself. A few shapes, even one shape at a day, is more than enough. After a couple of months or less, you will find out that you will know everything, and you know it just glancing at them. So take your time, this is a very important step, and review the video I've made about intervals. Number three, learn the octave shapes the notes are making. Actually, it's one simple recurring shape that you can learn almost immediately. So it's the easiest, probably the easiest of all the steps we are mentioning here. So, hardwire this shape into your brain, because it's a constant that won't change. Either you are viewing an A Dorian mode, for example, or A minor arpeggio, or I don't know, an A7 chord. It's always there. The pathway, we are talking about the pathway that your root is making. So, basically, if we take a random note, this one for example, and we must be able to see the octaves, okay, since it's the root of the octaves, from this part to the higher notes and to the lowers. If we go to the highers, for example, and we see that our root note, for example, is on the D string, then immediately our hand will go there. What I'm trying to say that we immediately know that the next root is here. We know this shape, and from this we definitely know that the next root is here. Okay, we know this by heart. So, as I've said before, hardwire this to your brain, play the shape, or better yet, take a piece of paper with a fretboard and try to make the shape with a pencil. Do it 2 or 3 times and you have learned it. It's not that hard, but even if it's not that hard, it doesn't mean it's not as important as the rest of the steps. In fact, is maybe it's more important, because as I've said before, whatever it is you are viewing, a mode, a chord, some weird stuff, it doesn't really matter. These shapes are your guidelines. Okay, so make sure you learn them so well that you see them immediately. Number 4, learn triads all over the fretboard. There are basically 4 chord families that contain all the chords you need or even don't need to know. It's major, minor, diminished and augmented. So the task here is to learn how they and their inversions appear on the neck. Of course, just by hearing that, you get tired. It seems like a lot of work, but it really isn't. I want you to start paying attention that every step we take isn't cut off from the rest, that you will start to connect stuff. What I mean by that? Every triad, for example, is made from the root, the third, you remember this shape, and the fifth. Okay, but all these intervals, of course, we learn them in the second step, or at least we have started to. So, if someone has paid attention to the second step, he already knows his intervals. So, to stack some of these intervals together and make triads, it certainly becomes a breeze. And not only that, but it actually makes sense for a change. Okay, so for example, if we take a note, 1, 3, 5, okay, it's easy to continue to do that all over the neck. Okay, this was just B major triads and we played on all string sets, but instead of trying to memorizing stuff, as I've said before, try to see the inner workings of them. Okay, if you really knew your intervals, you simply see 1, 3, 5. You don't get confused, you just go like that. Okay, so by now, if someone has already made an effort and paid attention to those 4 steps, things are starting to make sense. Of course, as I've said before, I'll make a detailed video about those things. I have already made detailed videos about the first 2 steps. Okay, so next, let's move on. 5. Learn your scales horizontally at first. I know you guys learn shapes of several types of scales, but until you can play a scale horizontally, you don't see its intervals clearly or get its sound in your head. So if you wanna go even further, it's better to not only play a scale horizontally, but actually be able to sing it before you play it. But of course, this is material for a future lesson. The point here is not to stop learning shapes, learning shapes is definitely useful, but if you don't have the sound or the visual intervals in your head, then you don't know it, even if you play the box shapes correctly. Okay, so you don't have to do much after you have put all the work learning triads, learning intervals, okay, learning the octave shapes and things like that. Use one string to play a scale that you are standing, for example, the natural minor. Okay, from the knowledge you have acquired, you must know that the next is one tone. Okay, then it's a semitone, and so on. So, by doing that, you start familiarizing yourself with the intervals. Okay, of course, you can say that I see the intervals when I play the shapes, but you really don't pay close attention. Believe me. Even if you do a simple exercise of soloing over a backing track and using only one string, then you will be forced to learn that string, learn those distances pretty well. So try it. It's very important, and you will see that even if you don't start trying to learn numerous shapes, only by doing this you will get the scale you want to learn ingrained in your head. So learn scales horizontally. Number 6, harmonize the scale you want to learn. That means make triads from each note of the scale, see what types of triads are created, the relationships between them, and after you do that, be able to play those chord scales all over the neck. Okay, so if we remember the previous example, when we start playing scales horizontally, you have to be able to make chords from each note of the scale. And so on. Okay. Doing that alone, we help you with your knowledge of the fretboard immensely. You don't even know how much it will help you. But take this seriously, and don't bother with anything else, with anything more complicated, until you get really, really good at a step like this one, because it's often that people get caught up to learn, to understand the modes and things like that, and they get frustrated if they don't. Of course, the reason is that before they tackle something like that, you have to learn the basics pretty well. And all these steps may be the basics, but 90% of the guitarists don't know them by heart. This is a big problem, and if you actually take some time and do that, you will be ahead of many of them in this term. So what I want to say about this step, of course, I will make a more detailed lesson later about this, but this step in particular, don't tackle it until you learn very well the first five ones. Okay, as we've said before, they are all related, but if you are not at least good, even if not great, at least good at the first five ones, then don't tackle number 6. Okay, you will know it, don't have to rush it, but take your time with each step. As you can see, learning the fretboard requires some effort from you guys, but the more you do it, the more you understand that all these steps are helping one another, so it's not as daunting as you may think it is. For example, knowing interval shapes makes it a breeze to learn triads, which makes it easier to learn to play chord scales, for example. So one thing helps another. You don't have to master each number before you move to the next. But as we said before, if we had to differentiate stuff, I would consider number 6 as the beginning of more deeper understanding of theory, so you can learn the first 5 almost simultaneously. Okay, a few minutes a day here and there on each, and you will get great at most of them in no time. So consider all this, it's really important, and start practicing them. Have fun.